Bandwidth for this podcast is brought to you by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
Welcome back to MacBreak Studio. I'm Mark, I'm here with Steve. We're talking about the new features in the 10.1.2 release, and you're going to go over some pretty cool stuff in that happens outside of Final Cut Pro 10.
Absolutely, in the Finder.
In the Finder.
Right, since Mavericks, there's these great meta tools for organizing your files, and in particular, your media files. You're going to see how cool this is. You can bring in Finder tags into Final Cut Pro, and they'll be organized by keyword collections.
So the Finder tags that you use in the Finder for a variety of things, totally unrelated to editing, but you can use them with in conjunction with Final Cut Pro.
It's fantastic.
Cool, let's check it out.
Let's take a look. So I'm going to jump out to the Finder, and here I have a folder called Ripple Underwater, and I open this up. I have a number of clips here, and they're all related to my favorite hobby, which is scuba diving. So I have a lot of clips in here from fishies, Caribbean, California diving. Now, I could put these into their own separate folders and import those folders as keyword collections, but this is even better.
Right.
Because I don't have to create folders.
Okay.
It's all about tagging. It's all about the metadata.
Because there's been this option for a long time to import folders as keyword collections.
That's correct.
So that was a way of organizing your media outside of Final Cut. This is a better
one. Oh, yeah. This is better. So let's say I have some marine life I want to bring in, and I want keyword collections based around marine life from these clips. So here I have some fishy clips here, so I'm going to command click those. And I have a sponge clip, and I also have a turtle clip here. So I'm going to command click these clips because I want to tag them as marine life.
As marine life, okay.
Right. So I'm going to click this button at the top of the Finder window, and that's a default button in every Finder window in Mavericks.
It's the edit tags button.
Edit tags button. So if I click this here, the edit tags little window comes up, and I'm just going to add my own tag.
Okay.
Although
it looks like previous, you've added a few.
Well, there's previous tags. Yes. Whenever you add a tag, it gets added to the tag library, which you can then modify and change in the Finder preferences.
Okay.
So I'm going to go ahead and type out marine life and hit return. And so I have a little token there.
And that has that just been assigned?
Just been assigned to those four clips.
Yeah. Okay.
Now, if I go show all, there's actually more tags here that I'm not seeing. It's just kind of giving me a short list.
Okay, but it shows all the tags you've set up or used previously.
Right, and I can click blue, and I've just tagged it with a color.
Okay.
Because, well, you'll see why in a minute. I like blue.
Okay.
So I've tagged essentially those four clips, and you can see they're blue.
The blue tag actually helps you see which ones you tagged.
Uh-huh. Right, but what's really great in the Finder, of course, if you type in marine life, it should bring up any clip that's tagged with that.
Because it's completely searchable within the Finder. Yep.
Completely searchable.
And in the Finder, you can do smart collections, or basically what you can kind of do in Final Cut to find those things.
It's all about the metadata.
Yep.
All right, so we're going to go back to Final Cut. And in Final Cut, I already have a library set up, and I have
an event.
And I'm going to bring that stuff, those four clips, or the entire folder, I'll just import.
Okay.
And a new feature is I can drag straight into the browser now.
Okay, so wait a minute. You've been able to drag onto an event to import rather than clicking that or rather than choosing file import. But now you can drag right into the browser. All right, let's see how this works.
Now, wait. Before we do that, we need to check our preferences.
Oh, because we want to know what's going to happen.
It's very important because I have this library. I don't know if it's set up as a managed library. I don't know if it's set up as an external media library.
Yeah.
And I just need to check that.
Check
but whenever time you do a drag and drop operation, you need to check your preferences.
Good idea.
So I'm going to hit Command, comma, bring this up. And right at the top here, there's a option for copying files to storage location if it's an external folder or to the library.
Or library, depending what you've set the thing up to be.
Right, and we've covered that in different Mac breaks.
Yes.
So I'm just going to choose leave in place.
Okay.
Right. But it's very important that you set this up ahead of time before you drag your clips.
So you know what's going to happen.
You know what's going
to
happen.
Is it going to copy to the location you've established, or is it going to leave them where they are?
Exactly. But here's the new thing. The keywords from Finder tags.
Okay.
Brand new.
Yes.
Fantastic. Like you mentioned, you could do it from folders, but I'm going to use this way more than I'm going to use folders because I get tired of making folders. Tags to me are so much faster.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go ahead and close this and open the Finder window and see. And this, what I should have done is had the window
set up
ahead of time. So I'm going to open the window. There it is. And then tab back to Final Cut. Tab back to Finder, so I can see both windows at the same time.
Yes.
So what I want to do is grab all these clips, or select all of them, and I grab them, and then drag them right into the browser.
Right into the browser. That's easier. And by the way, it's easier to target this big thing than to go over this tiny little event over there.
Right, but notice, look at the icon. I haven't released my mouse
yet. It's a little hooked arrow. That's telling you, hey, you have leave in place selected. So it's letting you know.
You're going to make SIN clips in your library.
It's telling you. Okay. Right. If you had selected copy to storage location, that would be a big plus symbol, right?
I believe so.
Yes.
I think maybe I can even over. I don't think I can override it here, but no. It's just showing you that I'm doing a
I remember when we talked about it before and you did it the other way, I saw a big plus symbol. Cool. Okay. So let's see what happens.
I have short-term memory loss, but whatever you say. Okay. So I'm going to release the mouse. There are all my clips.
Okay.
They're great. And it happens instantaneously because I'm not copying media.
Right.
So now, check it out. If I open up or spill open this little triangle, this disclosure triangle, check it out. There's my marine life.
Yes, there's all the four clips.
All four clips based on the tags in the Finder.
Fantastic.
And blue is going to have the exact same clips because I tagged them.
You tagged with both of those.
Right.
But the point is you can use multiple tags on the same clip.
That's right.
Which is something you can't do with folders.
That's right.
Because that's really cool because you can have all kind of mix. The same way Final Cut works is that database way. The Finder does that now.
That's right. In fact, what's great, and you mentioned this earlier, a key benefit, is you can have someone who doesn't even have Final Cut on their Mac going through and tagging things ahead of time so that when you import the clips, they're already collated.
So anybody could be an assistant editor and set this stuff up for you without even using Final Cut.
And they can just tags. It's great. And they can do it with folders before, but tags are just so much easier.
Yeah, but you just saved certain assistant editors $300.
Exactly. So since we're talking about importing, there's one little thing I want to show you that is new.
Okay.
It's a little thing. And again, it's always about enhancements that make our life easier, make things faster. You know, make our lives better so we can do other things besides in front of a computer. So what I want to do is select the event and go ahead and click the little import button.
Okay.
And I have my iPhone connected. And the reason I deliberately chose my iPhone because I have thousands of photos and videos.
I've yet to import.
Right, right. So there it is, Steve's iPhone. And I selected it right there in the import window. And you'll notice this little pop-up here. By the way, it says videos, photos, or all clips. So I can now look at just videos, just photos, or clips. And this is huge because if the default previous to this version was all clips. So it just showed
And if you're just looking for a video and you've got thousands of photographs, it can be hard to find that video.
I typically, when I work with the import window, I really do like to have it in thumbnail view so I can actually see what's here and I can actually skim through and see these clips. So there's only videos. If I go to photos, there they are.
Just
there's
photos.
All my photos.
That's
lots
great.
Of photos. It's great.
Simple thing, but a nice another little filtering option to help you more easily sift through a lot of media.
That was an iMovie first.
It's true.
That's right.
And it made its way up to the professional application.
It sure did. So that's all I have to say about importing enhancements.
Okay. Beautiful. Those are great tips. Very useful. Great ways to get organized. Hopefully it helps you and makes your work go better and faster. Thank you, Steve. Check us out, rippletraining.com. Follow us on Twitter. Check us out on Facebook. Thanks for watching. We'll be here again next week. And thank you again for watching MacBreak Studio.